Every day, nearly 100 new software vulnerabilities are discovered, and many are quickly exploited by attackers. The numbers are staggering and continue to rise, reflecting the increasing scale and sophistication of cyber threats. Unfortunately, this trend is only expected to worsen as many systems come online and cybercriminals become more adept at finding and exploiting weaknesses. For those who don't know, in cybersecurity, a vulnerability is a weakness or flaw in a system that can be exploited by a threat actor specifically to gain unauthorized access or cause damage. These vulnerabilities can exist in software, hardware, or even human practices. Many organizations struggle to patch vulnerabilities quickly, with some critical issues dating back to 2017 still exploited today. This underscores the need for effective vulnerability management and timely patching to protect against cyber threats. In 2023, nearly 30,000 new vulnerabilities were discovered, with about 19% of them being high or critical severity. Despite the availability of patches, 60% of data breaches occurred because organizations didn't apply these patches promptly. But what about the other side, the defenders? The vulnerability manager is at the forefront of this battle. Behind the scenes, they work tirelessly to keep digital infrastructure secure, analyzing threats, prioritizing vulnerabilities, and of course, coordinating responses. As a vulnerability manager, staying ahead of the curve means being informed about the latest threats. I begin by checking cybersecurity news and any alerts from our security tools. Knowledge is power in this field. Next, I review the vulnerability reports generated overnight. These reports are critical as they highlight potential weaknesses in our systems. These reports contain a variety of crucial information. Typically, I find details about the specific vulnerabilities identified, such as severity levels, categorized as low, medium, high, or critical, indicating the potential impact of a vulnerability if exploited. The affected systems, listing the specific servers, applications, or devices where the vulnerabilities were found. The detailed description of each vulnerability, including how they could be exploited. Also suggested remediation steps to mitigate or eliminate the vulnerability. And lastly, timelines, the information how long the vulnerabilities have existed and any previous attempts to address them. Here's an example of a high severity vulnerability that was detected last night. This could potentially allow unauthorized access to sensitive data. My job is to assess how quickly we need to address this and what resources we need. Vulnerability assessments are a core part of my role. Using advanced tools, I scan our systems and networks to identify any weaknesses. This proactive approach helps us stay one step ahead of cyber threats. Next up is our daily stand-up meeting with the security team. Communication is key. We discuss the vulnerabilities identified, our action plan, and the challenges we might face with patching specific vulnerabilities. Each team member has a unique role to play, from penetration testers to incident responders. Collaborations ensure we cover all bases and respond swiftly. After the meeting, I spend time coordinating patching with other departments. Security isn't just an IT issue, it's a company-wide priority. I work closely with departments, operations, and even HR to ensure our defenses are robust. For instance, if there is a vulnerability in our software, I need to ensure our developers are aware and have the resources they need to fix it. We now get together, I make phone calls to discuss patching specific systems from the earlier discussion I had with the security team. This is the moment where we include IT system admins and different stakeholders from the business to discuss patching specific assets. Now it's time to join a CAB meeting, where stakeholders gather each week to approve or deny specific changes. This time, we have an emergency patch, so our request is given priority. Our change has been approved for a specific window, during which system administrators or developers will implement the patch and secure our systems. As the day winds down, I document our findings and prepare a report for senior management. This includes a summary of the vulnerability addressed, any incidents, what we have done so far, and our action plans moving forward. Being a vulnerability manager is challenging, but it's incredibly rewarding. Knowing that I play a crucial role in protecting our company and its assets makes it all worthwhile. If you found this video insightful, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon for more behind-the-scenes looks at the world of cybersecurity. Until next time, keep your data safe and curiosity alive.